This is the third time you've been running for the office of the president. So why do you insist on becoming the president of Nigeria?
Well, first of all, let me start from a private perspective. I have many kids, children. I brought them up well, sent them to the best schools, both within Nigeria and outside. As I normally tell them, I have lived my life. But if I should bring them all back home, what kind of a country am I going to leave for them? I think this thinking that I have is a thinking behind every parent in this country. What kind of a country am I going to leave for my kids? Is it a better country than I found it or not? This is one of the reasons behind my perseverance, to run for the office of this country, not only for my kids, but for the future generation of this country, everybody's kids. The message I have for Nigerians at this point in time, vote out the APC. Compare our records. Nigerians have absolutely no reason to vote for APC.
Well, there are multiple candidates this time around.
Let us be realistic. Where is Labour in this country? Where is the structure? Where is Labour? No single member of local government, no state assembly, no House of Representatives, no Senate, no governor, no local government chairman, no nothing. Fine, they are starting. It's not bad to start. But you cannot start and at the same time be at the top.
But there seems to be popular among the youth.
Okay. Let the youth vote for them. It's their right.
Are you sure that you're going to win? You have a chance of winning?
This time around, I think I'm giving it my best shot and my all in all. And I'm confident.
So what happens if you lose?
That's my fate. I take it in very good faith.
Now, there are fears or rumors around your health status that you've been going around for treatment out of the country. Can you address that?
I don't go for any major treatment abroad other than normal medical checkup. The only medical problem I have was, if you recall, in 2006, in an election year like this, I tripped from staircase, and injured my knee. And I went to Germany for treatment. I didn't have any fracture. I just have what they call a tendon rupture. And then the tendon was brought back and ensued. That's the only sickness I have. And if the electoral authority says we should produce our medical report, I'm ready to produce my medical report.
In essence, are you saying that if you win the election, you're not going to travel out of the country for any form of medical attention?
As long as whatever medical attention I require is available in the country, I will avail myself of that facility. But if it is not available, what do you want me to do? To sit down and die?
As the president, you'll be, of course, you have all
the which is going to be cheaper for me to bring in medical personnel from abroad and equipment, or to fly in and out, whichever is cheaper for the country. That's what I'm going to do.
The APC wants you disqualified, and this is, of course, based on a leaked audio alleging that was your voice admitting to some corrupt practices. What can you say about that?
Well, all what I know, all corrupt practices or corrupt allegations against me have been investigated in this country more than anybody else, and nothing was found against me.
Well, this is a new audio. Was that your voice or not?
And that audio has disclosed nothing new.
It's not your voice?
Nothing new.
All the regions in Nigeria are facing one security challenge or the other. There is insurgency, banditry, farmer elder clashes. I can go on and on. So what plans do you have when it comes to security if you win the election?
Well, there are a number of approaches we have designed as a party and also as a presidential candidate. One of them is more boots on the ground, more equipment, and more training. The second aspect of that is also to consider creating state police where necessary, and so that you can have more levels of policing at various levels, at the state level, at the local government level, at the federal level.
Okay, see, the country's economy is also struggling at the moment, and there is a high inflation rate, which is hurting many Nigerians. Can you talk to me about your economic strategy?
Well, we have said that one of our major economic plans is how do we get, you know, massive private sector involvement in our economy. In other words, getting the private sector really to come in and pump as much investment as possible by giving them a lot of incentives. And of course, the second aspect of it is to make sure that we devolve, you know, more powers to the states and also the local government by reducing, you know, the size of the federal government. Every investor wants a secure environment. That's why, you know, in my 5-point program, you will see that security is topmost. You know, first of all, we must make sure that we restore security. Once we are able to do that, and then we give the private sector incentives to come in, you know, and invest in the country, you will see how massively they will come. Nobody will ignore a large market in Nigeria. This is one of the largest market on the continent of Africa.
Asuse strike is a recurring problem. So what are you going to do to address the issues around funding of universities to, you know, reduce?
I believe we have the capacity to fund universities to the barest minimum. And then particularly is all on the issue of, you know, payment or delayed payment of salaries. I think it's recklessness and lack of leadership. Nigeria can afford to pay its lecturers in time and good pay for that matter.
And you're confident that if you win the election, there will not be any form of ASUU strike?
I will sit down with ASUU and we will sort it out.
Civil society organizations have been calling for candidates to declare their assets and liabilities. Are you willing to?
I have always done that. The only thing is that, the law doesn't provide that we should make it public. If the law says we should make it public, I will make it public.
For the sake of transparency, and because you're always clamoring for change, don't you want to be the change you're preaching?
I don't mind. I can produce it. I mean, it is there. They have been there. I will produce them.
So will you produce it this time around? Is this something we can hold you to?
Why not?
Women and youths have continued to be sidelined in the affairs of Nigeria. What role will they be playing if you win?
I have already given a policy statement on youth and women participation in government. And it is quite disappointing that particularly on the side of women, despite all the incentives we give as a political party, free this, free that, and this and that, so much quota for women, they don't come forward. Even when we make opportunities easier for them, they don't seem to be coming forward. So I think maybe it's a stage of our development.
When you say they're not really coming forward, or the system is not viable enough for them to thrive, for example, the outgoing lawmakers abandoned about 5 gender bills, and then the House of Representatives promised that they were going to reconsider 3 of them. Until now, they have not even announced that the 3 bills in the House of Representatives.
If I get there, I will make them move.
Is that a promise?
Yeah, it's a promise. I'm very, very particular about gender, you know, equality and gender participation.
Okay.
I am pro-gender.
I remember you promising that if you win and at the end of your tenure, you would hand over power to the youth. What is the promise on that and how viable do you think?
If the youth come forward, supposing they don't come forward,
do you think the political
because system? You hardly find a young man who will contest an election once, twice, and contest again the third time. It requires perseverance, it requires consistency, and it requires patience. The youth may seem too much in a hurry,